Hello friends, my name is Amul and in this video I'm going to show you how you can run WordPress locally on your computer. So you need two things. The first one is server, the second one is WordPress itself. So I'm going to use xampp for this tutorial. However, you can use whatever server you want. You can use MAMP server, you can use WAMP server, but for this video I'm going to use xampp. And so you need to download this xampp and then run it, I mean install it. Once you have installed it, then you go to wordpress.org and then install the latest WordPress. And I've got 4.6.1 at this point of time. You have to just download it. And once you have downloaded, I already have downloaded it, so I'm not going to download it again. Once you have downloaded it, you simply have to extract and then get this file over here. So I already have WordPress, so here. And then you have to run the server. So I'm going to look for the server. Here is the xampp control panel. And you have to run these two, Apache and MySQL. So you have to click start, and then you can just close it. This runs in the background. Okay, now you have to put this WordPress folder in htdocs folder on this xampp. So there are two ways to go to htdocs. The first one is from here. The second one is you can go to start, then computers, C drive, xampp, and then here is the htdocs. Anyway, so now you are in here, htdocs. What you have to do, you can create one folder over here and name whatever you want. I'm going to name it WP. That's it. I'm going to open it and I'm going to just drag it over. That's all you need and you are done. So once it's over here, you simply can close these pages and launch your favorite browser, and then you can visit localhost because you are already running the server. So when you launch localhost, you'll get this one, the dashboard. Okay, so if you go ahead and launch localhost slash WP, that's the directory name, you'll get this one. However, we need to create a database for WordPress, so I'm quickly going to create a database. I'm going to name it whatever you can name. I'm going to name it WP, and then you create the database. The database has been created, it's already selected. You can go on to privileges. You will see there are a few users already created. So there are two users, root, which are available for localhost with all the privileges, but there's no password. However, if you want to create any other user, you can create a new user and then you are done. So here it is. I'm just going to refresh it and I have already selected English. I'm going to click on continue. Okay, database name, username, password, host, everything is okay. Now let's go. Database name is WP, username is root, which was already there. I don't have any password, I'm going to leave it. Localhost, you can change it if you want to. I'm going to click on submit. Run the install, and this is going to take a few moments here. I can name my site, let's say WordPress on Windows. Okay, username is going to be just so that I can remember it. Admin, you can name whatever you want to. Okay, I can just admin at wp.com. Okay, discourage search engine, whatever you want, you can do. Okay, Okay, then you have to confirm the password and then install the WordPress. That's it, and you are done. So let me quickly just go ahead and see what's there. Yeah, when you just install the WordPress, initially it takes time. So you'll have to be patient with me. Thank you so much. Yeah, we're done here. So login, you can choose the password. Your chosen password is already there. Success. And here you can just say admin. I already have admin password. You can click on remember now, remember me. So this is your WordPress, and you already have one default theme installed on this computer, which is 16, and it's already been there. So if you go to localhost WP, you'll get this 2016 theme. And then you can just, if you have to add another theme, you simply have to visit htdocs, which you can go here, and here's the htdocs folder. I already have one theme here. So in WP folder, you simply go to WP content. In the themes, you can add one more theme, but you'll have to download that. I have one here, I'm going to just add. So if I go to themes and refresh it, I'll get that theme here. So here is Serena. I will have to just activate it, and that has been activated. Just refresh it. This is the new theme which I just added to my themes folder. So that is it for this video. Please like, share and subscribe for my channel. Goodbye, take care people.